full screen.
First thing you'll notice is that I'm absolutely casual today, so sorry. This 6 o'clock kind of came as a surprise. Okay, let me see if I can turn this camera around.
Okay.
All right, so front porch. Really like this neighborhood. And this is actually, I've been in a lot of the houses around here. This is a... Hi, Megan.
Hey there.
This is a really cool cul-de-sac. Did you get my little videos I've been sending you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, good, good. So the drive-in is really nice, and you're in a really cool part of town. The house has been recently painted. The roof, I took, which is going to be hard to show you from here, but the roof is in really good shape. I don't know about the blue, but that's an easy fix. but the I mean, even the landscaping is really nice and everything. So we're going to come inside. This is the front door.
So Mike, let me just ask you a question. As I looked at the house, it has a very shallow sloping roof. How is that like with snow in Indianapolis? We've never lived in like heavy snow areas, so it doesn't have a big angle to it. So does snow just sit on it?
No, the snow will not just sit on it. I mean, it'll run off over there. Remember, this house has been around for 20 something years, maybe 30, and it's never been a problem. So you got to put that kind of age in it. And I wouldn't say that's a shallow roof by any means.
Okay.
It's not a, you don't get a good look at it from here. It's a hip roof.
Yeah.
But it's in good shape. The roof, the shingles look like they're in really good shape. I'd be surprised if it was more than 5 years old.
Okay.
Okay. Tile floor in the front hallway. These are really cool. These are little pocket doors, pardon the hand. But these are like pocket doors. So you got some French glass doors. Mm-hmm. So this is kind of like an office in the front room. Baby changing station for you guys if you want.
There you go.
This is so much easier when there's not some crazy Asian woman in here. okay. So I'm going to kind of wander through. You know, I haven't even looked in this room over here. I suspect this is the dining room. So you come in the front door, and there is the office to the left with the pocket doors.
Okay.
Coat closet, stairs going up, which I haven't seen yet. dining room. Okay. So we'll kind of walk through the dining room, so the main hallway. Cute little kitchen, electric stove, white cabinets. I mean, I can't wait to show you the backyard. The yard is amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's like a laundry and a bath down there. We'll go there in a second. Let's walk over here and see this. So, again, we just kind of walked around this wall here to get to the from the front door. I'm going to walk back up here again. That's the dining room.
Hey, Mike, can I get you to hold on a second? We're trying to sign this thing, and I don't want Cal to miss out on the kitchen. I accidentally signed my stuff at the beginning, and I messed it all up. Can you just X out of it and then start again?
Go ahead, Mike. Go ahead.
Okay, if you guys need to sign, go ahead. That's most important there.
Sorry about this.
Wish there was a way to make that picture bigger.
So...
So, Mike, the issue with the signing thing is Megan put her signature down, but it's got my name on everything. So, do you know if there's a way to change that signature, or do we need Renee to send us a new one?
I think if you're both on the signature, so if Megan signs first, it's going to auto-populate after you're done into your email after this, Cal.
Okay.
So it'll have your signature on one and then her signature on the other. Just both of you do it and they'll both populate on there.
Okay.
She's just apparently got the emails mixed up.
Gotcha.
Are you checking this yard out though? This place
I know.
Is so
it's a great. So go ahead and continue doing the walkthrough. We'll
just going to hang out in the backyard, man. This is nice and quiet. Honestly, guys, I told the agent, if you guys don't buy this house, I might. But in all seriousness, if you do buy it, you won't have a problem selling it on the back end, because Renee and I are kind of looking for a high-end rental in this area, and this would be a nice place for it.
Very cool. Very cool. Okay. Well, who says we're not going to rent it whenever we're done with it?
And you'd be wise to. Yeah. I really would.
All right, go ahead and continue going, Mike. We'll continue talking.
Okay.
Go ahead.
That was the front door, right? And okay. When you come in the front door, there was the pocket door, which is not at my right, but would be the left as you came in, and the dining room. And then you come past this little space, and that's the basement going downstairs.
Okay.
Okay. Then you walk into the kitchen. So when I'm looking off to the right, there's your kitchen.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to kind of pan around here slowly. There's the back deck, which really should have an umbrella and a picnic table under it. It's almost a shame. And that, now, the living room isn't huge, but, you know, you got room for a big couch and a TV, and it's got that looks like a real fireplace, full stone wall, same stone that's on the outside.
Awesome. Okay.
And you walk out into this massive backyard. Full fence all the way around the whole yard. They've clearly got a kids here. I mean, their kids look like they're toddlers. Grass is perfect.
Yeah. Yeah.
We've got true Kentucky bluegrass. None of that Orlando crabgrass you guys have. It's a really nice yard. Mature trees all the way around. All shady all the time.
Yeah.
So this is the south side of the house. So the sun would kind of set over, well, rises over here, sun would set that way. You wouldn't really see the sunset so much, but there's a playset in the backyard, big playset.
Okay.
Can you see that from there? That's kind of, yeah. It doesn't really zoom well.
Yeah.
And my picture is like a half a square inch, so if I'm not getting
No, you're good. You're good, yeah.
Our Bethan would love that.
Yeah, that looks great. Yeah.
But there's a fence around the entire yard, so you can let them out without too much worry.
Okay.
And then the parking lot has a basketball court. We'll go into the garage there in a minute. They did a really nice job on this deck. It's all been recently stained and treated. They definitely did a great job getting this place ready for market.
Yeah.
So, big deck here. Again, the roof back here looks nice.
Can you show us how much clearance between the tree above you and the roof there is?
It looks like they've already trimmed it back. You really can't see it from that little tiny picture I'm showing you, but they've trimmed it off the roof, so it's not touching at all.
Okay.
I wouldn't worry about that. That's not a tree I'm concerned about.
Okay.
You were asking about the Indiana snow over here. I mean, we had Snowmageddon a couple of years ago, and for Hoosiers, that's a big deal. I'm from Vermont, man. We get like 80, 90 inches of snow all the time. They get 6 inches of snow here. It's a big deal.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they don't get like, you know, 2-3 feet like we do in other places. Let's go up or down, folks.
Well, can we take a look at the kitchen a little bit closer?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yep. That's exactly what I'm here. Okay. So on this side of the cabinet, again, I'm in the den here.
Okay.
So when I look toward the kitchen, there's that island. It looks like a little mother's desk off here to the left.
Okay.
Okay. And a couple of chairs at the counter. That's bar height counters. And there's actually under here, there's these nice little kind of cabinets on both sides.
Okay.
Kind of a bar height to counter height step up right here.
And is that Formica on the as countertops?
Yeah, it's laminate.
Laminate, okay.
Yeah, that's an easy fix. And if it was mine, guys, I'd put stainless steel appliances in it and a backsplash and new counters before I sold it again.
Yeah, but yeah.
For $214, I mean, this is phenomenal, man.
Yeah. If you walk straight, that's going to take us back to the garage?
Yes, so you would actually be coming in the house every day from this door right here. I'm going to shut this for a second. Well, let's show you the garage. I left the door open because it's hard to see in here that the light didn't work.
Okay.
So it's a two-car garage. It's not a big two-car, and it's full of stuff.
Yeah.
But you can easily get two cars in here if you don't pack it full of stuff.
Okay.
Okay. And then there's actually a walk-up or pull-down storage, so they have a storage up in the attic up there as well. Whoops.
Yep.
Sorry, I had an incoming call. They couldn't pick a worse time, could they? Okay. So when you walk into the house, you're going to come in and see this to the right, half bath in front of you.
Okay.
And then to the right is a nice laundry room, all tile, cubby holes.
Yeah, look at that.
Door to the let's just see where that goes. Okay, yeah, this just takes you out to the driveway. You're on this side of the fence, but there's kind of a gate in the fence there.
Okay, can you show us the neighbor's house, like how close that is? Sorry.
Yeah, let's see. This is not actually to the right, it's kind of around the corner.
Okay.
So, like, that's the side view of the house, your yard over there.
Yeah.
So that, if you can see over the top of the car, there's a brown house in the distance.
Okay.
That's got to be 90, 100 yards from here. Now, that guy's kind of close to the property line, but he's not really in the front of the house, and he's not really on the side. He's kind of off on a 45-degree angle there.
Okay.
So he wouldn't really see him from any window at all.
Okay.
That is your backdoor neighbor. Let me see. There's one. You have a really long backyard, so you actually have two backdoor neighbors there. So your fence goes way over to that corner. See where the blue shed is?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the corner of your property there. And your backyard, goodness gracious, that's got to be – oh, 75 yards, maybe 80.
Yeah, I did an acreage lookup on Google Maps, and it said it was 0.44 acres is a lot.
Yeah, I was going to say half acre, so I thought I overestimated a little bit. The agent's asking for our feedback. I'm like, she needs to hold her shirt on here a little bit.
Okay.
All right, so let's go back in that door. So what you see on this side of the house is the garage door. So you got the driveway coming up from the cul-de-sac there, and you got this little turnaround area here.
Yeah.
And then that door we just came out right there.
Nick is into the laundry room.
Yes, so he's going to walk through that door, goes into the laundry room. Yep.
Laundry room. Cubby holes are really nice.
Yeah,
like
those are very cool cubby holes.
Little windows, and then there's cabinets that they did that match the kitchen.
Very nice.
And
that's the half bath.
Little bath here. Oh, little wainscoting on the wall. That's cute.
So you have access to the laundry room from the outside, and then you have garage access to the house too, which is separate.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is really nice. I mean, this is an 80s style floor plan, but it's surprisingly open. I would bet that this area right here has been opened up. That probably wasn't open in the original floor plan.
Yeah.
And they opened it up since then just to kind of get a more open concept in here.
Okay.
And looking back toward the dining room, let's go upstairs and see the bedrooms.
Yeah.
Okay.
You good with that floor?
Good with that floor. I'd be interested in looking at the windows a little bit and just seeing by your guesstimate how old those windows might be. Are they single pane? Are they double pane?
They're double pane. They're wood. They're in really nice condition, but they are not brand new. They may be original, but they're solid as can be. And
okay.
I'd like to tell you, I can tell you who the manufacturer is, and I can't see the watermark on here.
Okay.
Newer windows put watermarks on. Okay. So again, front door, you come off to the right, and we go up the stairs.
Okay.
You got motion sickness watching this?
Yeah. I've got the patches on. I'm good.
Okay, so when you come up to the top of the stairs, there's what looks like master there. That's probably a linen closet, bathroom, and two bedrooms. So I'm just going to work my way around to the four bedrooms. First one on the left. Oh, my. Nursery.
Okay.
This is cute. She's got, that's actually a deeper closet than it looks like because she's got all those big shelves in there for the baby stuff.
Okay.
Okay.
Is that like an arm's length deep, you would say?
Is it like a what now?
Arm's length deep, the closet.
Yeah, it's a reach in.
Yeah. You know. Okay.
Okay.
But there's no door on it, right?
No, but it had one on it, and I imagine it's in storage. They just pulled it off to put the curtains on there. But you can see where the hinges were.
Okay.
Yeah.
You can see that. Okay.
Okay.
They like green. They got green downstairs. And green
actually,
upstairs.
While you're in there, can you look at that window and? Is that window one that you can open?
Yeah. Oh, they're cool. Pella windows, which is a nice brand.
Okay.
Yeah, they are. You can open the windows for sure.
Okay. Great. And full screens on them, yeah.
Yeah, full screens. Well, at least there's screens on the front of the house. I'll check the back. Okay, so they actually have new doors. Those are not original, so they put all new doors and hardware in the house at one time.
Okay.
Those are cool. Hollow core, but they're
cool
looking.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is bedroom two. Looks like a guest bedroom.
Okay.
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 The linen does not come with the house, but match the bedspread to the wall.
Yeah, seriously.
So what are these? Hold on, I gotta open these two doors.
Yeah.
Okay, so just two individual closets there. Let me back up so you can see that better.
Okay, and they
I
do
just
not.
Came in that door
do they
right
connect
there,
to each other?
Those two closets.
Yeah.
Okay.
And those closets don't connect. They've got two separate doors for two different sides.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
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 That looks like where Mister keeps his stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, let's move it, or unless they have a living grandpa or something. All right, so this is, again, we came up the stairs. There's the stairs.
Yeah.
Came up, we went to bedroom one, which was the nursery. Bedroom two was the grandpa's room there. And then bedroom three with the bunk beds.
Okay.
Which, again, is super cool. It looks like the same thing. They have two individual doors in the wall for closets.
Okay.
Let me just open those up for you.
Yeah.
Kind of hard to get into the picture when you're this close.
No, I hear you. I hear you.
So, I mean, it's not a massive room, but it's, I don't know, 11 by 12, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Okay, so two of those. The bunk beds make it a little funky.
Okay.
Okay.
8-foot ceilings all around.
Yeah, so it looks like the three bedrooms over here share this bath.
Okay.
Which is a double sink, really nice, got a cool floor in it.
Yeah.
The carpet up here looks like it's in really good shape. The walls in the hallway are at least neutral, kind of a two-tone neutral.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you show me, like, the fixture in the bathtub and all of that?
Yeah, it looks like they replaced the tile.
Oh,
yeah.
Beautiful. Oh, yeah.
So it's not fiberglass. It's got an old cast iron tub down there.
Nice.
You said that's cast iron? Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, it's hard to tell. I'm pretty sure that's cast iron. It could be Formica, but it's heavy. And I'm sure that's original. It looks like they pulled the fiberglass surround out and redid the tile.
Okay.
Yeah, the tile's really pretty.
And then the sink's nice. Fixtures in the sink.
Okay.
They've been replaced. Light fixtures are kind of cool. It's hard to get into the picture.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Okay. I should be turning my lights off as we go. Okay.
And that's a linen closet in the back of it. Yeah.
Okay. So we kind of came up these stairs and we got to make a hard right to come around the corner. But all the hardware has been replaced in the house. That's just a quick linen closet.
Okay.
Okay. Master bedroom has hardwood.
Cool.
Okay.
Ceiling fan clearly works. I'm going to get over to the other side of the room so you can see it better.
Do those photos stay with the wall? Those are load-bearing photos, right?
Yes, it's load-bearing photos. You can even have those lovely flowers that are sticking off the wall.
Perfect.
Yeah, worked for me. Okay, so they ran the hardwood into a bathroom that they clearly renovated as well.
Okay.
All right, let's see.
I don't know, those kind of look whenever he walks back out.
Okay, bathroom looks cool. Okay, so yeah, they redid this whole thing too. New light fixtures, new sink, new vanity, countertop. And here is a shower, new tile, new shower pan, floor, commode, hanging thing in the back.
Okay.
And then there's kind of like a little linen closet to the right of it that doesn't have a door.
Okay.
Wainscoting on the walls. Okay.
Okay.
Closet's bigger than I expected. Looks like it's all her clothes. He's down in the hallway.
Built-in shelving, okay.
Yep. Okay.
So that's a single sink, is that correct?
Yeah, single sink.
And it looked like a pocket door on the bathroom?
Let me go back. Not too fast. No, to come into this room right here, there is no door on this opening right here.
Okay.
So it's kind of open to here.
Okay.
You could put one in there, but there's not now. And so the linen to the left. The tub and the stool are to the left.
Okay.
Or the counter, and then that over here. So there's a door here.
Great. Yep. Sorry, I thought I just seen a pocket, and I was just making sure. Okay.
Oh, good questions. That's what I'm here for, to get you to see what you can't see from there. Okay. Let's.
Mike, as you walk down this hallway, just peek your head into those bedrooms. Do they have light fixtures on the ceiling, or are they? Fans or nothing. Perfect.
No, first one does not have a light fixture on it. Second one, none of them. The nursery has a ceiling fan.
Okay. Okay.
The others do not.
Okay.
Now it's got attic space, so if you wanted a ceiling fan and they're running a fan in here, it's a piece of cake.
Okay.
I'm sure all the wires run through the attic as it is. We good upstairs?
We're good upstairs.
Yeah. There's not attic access from the upstairs though, right?
There has to be attic access by code, so it's probably like in a closet or something. I didn't really see that. It's probably in the master. There's tiny attic access. There's probably more than that, but by code you have to have attic access.
Okay.
Okay, let's go down the stairs.
As you're walking, we're looking at questions that we had, so.
So one of the questions that we have
is, like, new carpet, new paint, newer. Okay, there's the stairs.
Okay.
The bottom of the stairs, there's a room to the left, that's actually concrete wall. That's not, that's been painted.
Okay.
And that's drywall in the back.
Okay.
That looks like a little playroom here for the kiddos. That looks like your water shut off right there. So it is a basement, but it smells really fresh. It's not like it's musty or anything down here. Ooh. And it's got a bar. Okay, so there is kind of a nice sitting area with a TV, which is nice. Now, they had a TV upstairs by the fireplace, if you remember.
Yeah.
It's a true basement, you know. It's got a drop ceiling, and that's a little tiny kind of window well type window.
Okay.
But the basement bar is really nice, like a little kitchenette down here.
Yeah.
So there's a...
Okay.
Kind of a cool butcher block
bar top. Yeah.
Cool lights. I'm gonna open up all these doors. I suspect it's all just there's your water heater and your furnace. That's on the back side of the bar. Cinder block wall back there again. Bone dry in the here. Sorry.
Can you see how old that water heater is by any chance? I know they said it's a new furnace, but I don't know. Okay.
102907.
And that's a 60. Okay.
It looks brand new. I got to tell you, I'm wondering if they if he wrote 07, he meant 17, because it looks brand new.
Okay.
But we can check on that. Plus, we'll ask them for a home warranty.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, this is more than I expected here. Let me find the light.
Oh, man, that's a whole nother room. Okay.
Yeah, a whole nother room. There we go. Okay. So, again, let me back up to show you where we are. When you come into the big room here, you got the big room here.
Yeah.
Back corner over there by the where you see the white door that I left open. That's where the water heater was. And then the refrigerator here, you come over to this door here. And so there's a whole other storage area down here.
Yeah, look at all that.
I got to give you a warning. Okay, I don't know how much stuff you've accumulated, but my wife and I moved from 1,100 square feet right around the corner to 4,700.
Yeah.
And we have now managed to pack $4,700 square feet. No. So, but you do have room to store here if you need it.
Yeah, we are currently in an 1170. So, yeah. 1100 square foot house right now. So, yeah.
Okay, let's get this. Give me a second here, guys, while I get these lights. Okay, so that's kind of the whole house. Is there anything you want me to show you?
So we had some buddies buy a house recently, and they got into it and flushed the toilet, and there was a huge issue with the plumbing. Is there, can you turn on, like, the water and, like, the sink or something and see what the pressure is like?
Yep, hold on. So we'll do that. The kitchen sink, that's kind of the center of the whole beast. Yeah, I don't suspect water pressure is going to be an issue around here. I believe the water tower is pretty close.
Okay.
So this is an RO system, which in Indiana is a great thing because the water here is not terrific.
So that's a water filter in the house? Is that what that is?
Yeah, that's an in-house osmosis system. That's your drinking water. And the drinking water is fine out of the tap if you can taste chlorine in some months.
Okay.
Looks like it's pouring out of there.
Gotcha.
Let me check the bathroom just for fun.
Your realtor really wants you to make a decision.
Yeah, hold on one sec. I just lost you guys. Where'd you
go? You're good.
Yeah, water pressure seems fine.
Okay.
Now, you were going to have an inspection, too.
Yeah. So I guess that's my question. So if we put a bid, if we put an offer in today... What's the process? They get to think about it overnight, or they get to counter, accept, or deny, and then we still have an inspection phase to go. We still have a couple other phases to go, correct?
Now, forgive me, I didn't see your offer before it was written, but it's probably, you got 2 weeks to inspect. They probably want an answer by tonight or tomorrow morning. We asked for an answer because we're in a competitive bid. But yeah, you've got 2 weeks to have the house inspected and responded to. So the day we get an acceptance, I'm going to send you guys a list of contractors. Everybody on the list I send you is going to be good. There's probably 50 others in Indianapolis that are not on that list. If they're not on that list, there's a reason for it.
Okay.
So to pick one from the list, the guy I used for my own house personally is a guy named Christian Sternad at Iron Gate Inspection. I thought he was terrific and he was very thorough.
Okay.
And I see him around town a lot. He's very good. Some of the other companies are great big companies. They're kind of Tucker allies. We do a lot of business with those guys.
Yeah.
But, you know, they've probably got 50, 60 guys working for them, and you never really know who's going to show up at the house. I like knowing when I work with Christian that Christian's showing up for work.
Totally. While you're over here, would you stop by the fireplace and just peek inside of it and just see, like... It looks wood burning from...
It's true wood burning, and there's wood ash in the bottom.
Yeah.
Another question for you, Mike. We looked up online, and we saw kind of the property values of the houses that are around in it, and it looked like this one was more expensive than the others. Again, since we're first-time home buyers, what we've heard is that you don't want to buy one of the most expensive houses in the neighborhood.
I have to check on those numbers because some of those houses might be smaller. If you're dealing with Trulia and Zillow, that number is entirely inaccurate. I'll have to pull up a market analysis to sell it to you. But the cool thing is that your bank will not allow you to pay too much money for the house. You're protected.
Okay.
So the contract is void if the house does not appraise. So somebody that knows what they're doing with appraisals, I'm going to shut the garage door, is going to take a look at it, and then so you're protected there. I'll run some numbers for you too, but we can, you know, if any time during this thing you don't feel like you like what you're hearing or as far as the purchase value,
yeah,
we can withdraw the offer. So what I'm thinking is we can submit the offer, and before we submit earnest money, which will need to be right away, we got 48 hours to submit the earnest money.
Okay.
We should absolutely. You guys all done inside?
Yeah, I am.
I think so.
Okay. I can flip this around so you can actually talk to me. Hi.
Hey there.
Okay.
We're going to flip you around so you can see both of us.
Calling me right now, okay. So she wants an answer. Find out if you guys like it. She's called three times since I've been in the house.
Yeah.
Okay. Why don't you give us just a couple minutes. We'll call you right back.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye.